Now the structure of family. The family is an organized group of blood relationship. Following are the main elements of the structure of family. So we all know that a family is a well organized group of all those persons who are related to each other through blood. And the main elements of the structure of family are three. Number one, affinal relationship. The family begins with the marriage of the persons of opposite sex. One will be a male and the other will be a female. Though the husband and wife may never have children, yet they constitute a family. So if there are no children, then also the husband and wife will be called as a family. Every family is not necessarily a biological group. The couple may adopt a child. Then the adopted son is the member of the family. The family may have any conjugal relationship with affinity. If the husband and wife do not have children of their own, and if they adopt a boy or a girl, then that adopted boy or girl will also become the member of the family. In this way, family may have any conjugal relationship with affinity. The second element of the structure of family is consanguineous relationship. The family is a kinship group. Kinship means blood relation, blood relatives. The biological interconnection is the consanguineous relationship. So biological interconnection among the persons is said to be the consanguineous relationship, which is defined as kinship. The members of the family are related to one another through the process of procreation. Means giving birth to others, to the future generation. Then the third element is dual membership. Every individual acquires membership in two family groups. An individual first takes part in a family which is the family of orientation. And then after a certain period of time, he himself procreates and starts new family called family of procreation. So there are dual membership in a family. First, the person is a part of a family, means अपने father or mother का बेटा या बेटी. This type of family is called as the family of orientation. Then after some time, he or she gets married and they also produce children. So now, first he was the part of the family of orientation. Now he becomes the part of the family of procreation, in which he has children of his own. Nuclear family is a family of procreation for the parents, and it is family of orientation for the children. Now, types of families. Number one, nuclear family. A nuclear family is one which consists of the husband, wife, and their unmarried children. Husband, wife, or unke bacche, जिनकी अभी तक शादियां नहीं हुई हैं। द चिल्ड्रन लीव द हाउस होल्ड एज सून एज दे आर मैरिड बिकॉज दे आर एंगेज समवेयर इन देयर ऑक्यूपेशंस एट डिफरेंट प्लेसेस सो दे टेक देयर द सन टेक द ब्राइड्स एट द प्लेस वेयर दे आर डूइंग देयर जॉब. This is a basic grouping of mates and their offsprings. This is the smallest composite family unit. Nuclear family is the smallest composite family unit. The solidarity of the nuclear family is largely dependent upon the sexual attraction and companionship between husband and wife and between parents and small children. So, the relationship is in a nuclear family is between the husband and wife and between the parents and the small children. The nuclear of clustered relationships in it are 8 in number. They are husband-wife, father-son, father-daughter, mother-son, mother-daughter, brother-brother, brother-sister, sister-sister. Then the second type of family is the extended family. The extended family consists of two or more nuclear families affiliated through an extension of the parent-child relationship. That is by joining the nuclear family of the married adult to that of its parents. So where two nuclear families join together, that becomes an extended family. Say the now the joint family. Joint family is a group of people who generally live under one roof. एक छत के नीचे रहेंगे. Who eat food cooked at one hearth. एक चूल्हे पे बना खाना खाएंगे. Who hold property in common. And who participate in common family worship and are related to each other as some particular type of kindred, blood relatives, ek dusre. Joint family consists of more than one primary family. All the members are blood relations or close kins. The joint family includes old parents, their sons, sons, wife and children. Joint family generally consists of three or more generations. So, in a joint family, three or more generations live together in a single house. They cook and eat food made on the same hearth. एक ही चूल्हे पे बना खाना खाते हैं. दे शेयर अ कॉमन प्रॉपर्टी एंड दे पार्टिसिपेट इन ऑल द फैमिली फंक्शंस, रिलीजियस फंक्शंस, रिचुअल्स, सेरेमनीज टुगेदर एंड दे हैव सम ब्लड रिलेशन विद ईच अदर. देन द पैट्रियार्चल फैमिली. अ पैट्रियार्चल फैमिली. In a patriarchal family, father is the main source of authority. All the authority are exercised by the eldest male of the family. Then matriarchal family. The matriarchal family is the family in which authority lies with the eldest female member. The eldest female member of the family has the maximum authority. Authority in the matriarchal family may also be exercised by the eldest brother of the female who looks after her children's needs or the eldest brother of the female. Sabse bada mama has the maximum authority and he looks after the children, the well-being of his sister. Property is transferred through the mother and only female succeed with the chief characteristic of matriarchal family is that the children are brought up in the homes of the wives. अपने ननिहाल में बच्चों की परवरिश होती है। देन पैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली, इन द पैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली डिसेंट्स और एंसेस्ट्री इज ट्रेस्ड टू द पैरेंटल, टू द पैटर्नल लाइन, फादर से डिसेंट्स एंड एंसेस्ट्री का को ट्रेस किया है। देन मैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली व्हेन डिसेंट्स और एंसेस्ट्री इज ट्रेस्ड थ्रू द मदर इज नोन एज मैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली। सो द एंसेस्ट्री इज ट्रेस्ड थ्रू द मदर इन मैट्रिलिनियल फैमिली। पैट्रिलोकल फैमिली, इन द पैट्रिलोकल रेजिडेंस फैमिली द वाइफ गोज एंड लिव्स इन द हाउस ऑफ हर हस्बैंड, मीन्स वाइफ विल स्टे विद द फैमिली ऑफ हिज हस्बैंड, दैट इज पैट्रिलोकल। देन मैट्रिलोकल फैमिली, इन द मैट्रिलोकल रेजिडेंस फैमिली द हस्बैंड गोज एंड लिव्स इन द हाउस ऑफ हिज वाइफ, घर जवाई बनकर के रहेगा। बायोलोकल फैमिली, द मैरिड कपल मे चूज बिटवीन एस्टेब्लिशिंग देयर रेजिडेंस विद द ब्राइड ग्रूम्स पेरेंट्स और विद द ब्राइड्स पेरेंट्स। सो इन अ बायोलोकल फैमिली इट इज द चॉइस ऑफ द मैरिड कपल वेदर दे आर गोइंग टू लिव इन द ब्राइड ग्रूम्स, विद द ब्राइड ग्रूम्स फैमिली और विद द ब्राइड्स फैमिली। एवन कुलोकल फैमिली, द ब्राइड एंड ब्राइड ग्रूम गो टू लिव विद द ब्राइड ग्रूम्स मैटरनल अंकल, दैट इज द ब्रदर ऑफ द ब्राइड ग्रूम्स मदर। सो द हजबेंड एंड वाइफ दे विल लिव विद द मैटरनल अंकल, मामा के घर पे जाके रहेंगे। In a combination of matrilocal and avunculocal residents, the couples live in alternate years with the bride's parents and the bridegroom's maternal uncle. And when there is a combination of matrilocal and avunculocal residents family, then there is a choice that in 1 year they will stay with the bride's parent and in the next year with bridegroom's maternal uncle. Neolocal family, if both the bride and bridegroom live in separate residence at their workplace, it is called neolocal resident family. It is also called changing residence family, as neither husband nor wife permanently live in each other's residence but live alternatively at each other's residence. A new local family is where the bride and the bridegroom, they live in separate residence at the place where they are working, and they will meet each other and stay with each other for some time, and permanently they will not stay with each other. So such type of family is called new local family. Then consanguine family, the consanguineal family is a nucleus of blood relatives surrounded by a fringe of spouses, that is sisters, brothers, etc. Then conjugal family or immediate family, conjugal family is a nucleus family of spouses and their offsprings surrounded by a fringe of relatives. In it, only husband and wife live together with their unmarried children. Then monogamous family, it is the type of family in which if one man is allowed to have only one woman and neither of them is allowed to have more than one at any stage. Polygynous family, if the family consists of one man and several wives, it may be called as polygynous family. Polyandrous family, if the family consists of one woman and several husbands, it may be called as polyandrous family.